Delta Dawn, what's that flower you have on? Could it be a faded rose from days gone by? And did I hear you say he was...
What's poppin', chat? What's good, everybody? Hope all of you doing great. Have a big week of Delusionals Dynasty this week. Not only because we just finished week 7, halfway through the regular season, but also because this week is week 1 of the college football season. Got a big week going on in Delusionals Dynasty to start the college football season. Looking forward to it. So let's go ahead and get right into the Delusionals Dynasty breakdown. Like we've been doing, we'll do the week 7 game of the week, do the rest of the week's breakdowns, power ranking for this week, look into next week's game of the week, and we'll go from there. So starting things off, we go to the week 7 game of the week as Jeff's Stanford Cardinal head to South Bend to take on the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. The Cardinals started the game off strong with a nice go route to take the early lead and put them on the board 7-0 in South Bend, taking a big advantage. But then on their very next drive, they're pinned on their own one, and the Irish force a safety that start the downhill slide of the game and actually the end of the highlights. We don't have many more from Jeff's boys this game as they go down 51-20 to the Irish and take their first loss of the season, unfortunately. Jeff's boys will have to look to bounce back up in the coming weeks, you know, but this is a tough loss. I think it's actually the first loss that we've had Delusionals Dynasty for game of the week. So, pretty tough one. So let's hope that Jeff and his boys can bounce back. Next, we head to Houston as Krish's ASU Sun Devils take on the Houston Cougars. They just squeaked out a win this week, 45-35, to win and get back on track after their bye week following the loss. Next, we head to Bowling Green as they host Northern Illinois. Wade and his boys were absolutely embarrassed, going down 62-7 and dropping to 2-4 on the year. It's going to be tough sledding for them from here on out. So let's hope Wade can get his boys back on track to end the season. Next, we head over to Rice as they host their in-state conference opponent, Temple. Ben and his boys continue rolling, taking this one 49-17 and jumping to 5-0 after last week's bye week. Next, we check on the Mean Green of North Texas as Nick and his boys also have an American Conference opponent this week in FAU. Never a doubt they weren't going to win this one. Nick and his boys won 45-17 and jumped to 6-0 on the year. Next, the Indiana Hoosiers host new Big Ten opponent USC, and it still doesn't feel right to say that USC is in the Big Ten. Chet and his boys get beat down 52-33, continuing their downhill slide with their second straight loss on the season. Let's hope Chet and his boys can get back on track, as they seem to be one of the few teams that are actually struggling in this dynasty. Next, we head over to Nashville as Seth and his Vanderbilt Commodores host Texas A&M. Beth and his boys continue to impress, winning 34-31 and jumping to 4-2 on the year. Beth continues to be one of the most impressive coaches this year, taking Vanderbilt from what many believe was not a great team and helping them compete in the SEC. It's been awesome to watch him so far halfway through this season. Next, Austin and his Old Dominion Monarchs head to the Peach State to take on Georgia State. They continue their win streak with a score of 50-38, improving to 5-1 on the year. Next is Cameron W. and his Colorado State Rams. We had an interesting situation with the offensive coordinator for CSU this week, as he had to miss this week's game due to a volunteering obligation. And because of that, and him letting us know ahead of time, he was actually given a forced win, and we advanced the week. So Cameron does get the win, but it was under little strange circumstances, but we're not going to punish him for it because, you know, he had something, you know, very good going on or something. He was doing something very good, so we're not going to punish him for it, but went ahead and gave him the win. But that's the situation with him. Next, we had two bye weeks this week as Tyler's UAB Blazers get a breather and Jacob's Baylor Bears also get a breather leading into the second half of this season. And finally, we have the last team of the week, Cameron P's FIU Panthers. We do actually have highlights for this in-conference matchup, so we'll get right to those. We start with a nice screen pass that leads to an absolute monster truck stick from the FIU back. Shortly after that run, the Panthers punch in a short dive to take the 7-3 lead. Next, we jump to the fourth quarter with the Panthers down 7 and see a nice deep crossing route by the FIU slot receiver to take it the distance and tie the game up at 28. Now we jump to less than a minute to go where FIU pounds in a short run to take the lead but leave time left on the clock for the Flames of Liberty. And now we jump to a press conference view of FIU's defense. We start this defensive highlight with 3rd and long after the Panthers D got a good sack on Liberty to set them at 3rd and 17. And they give the QB time to make a play and set up a 4th and 10. And with time winding down, Liberty hurries to the line where the QB has to dump it off and the pass is broken up to secure the win for FIU. And then we have one last highlight as we see the Panthers throw some salt in the wound on this in-conference rival and score again to make the final 42-28 and advance to 6-1 on the year. Next, we have the Week 7 Power Rankings. Each week, I'm going through our league and looking at how each team has done up to this point in the season and rank them according to their performance and record. Extra emphasis will be put on user games for these rankings, and this is a pretty big one since this is halfway through the season, so second half, some teams got to really improve and some teams got to keep on pumping like they are. Starting things off this week, North Texas continues rolling at 6-0 and remains number one, with Rice following up close behind at 5-0, second place. Next, with this week's number three losing, CSU jumps up to the number three spot. They round out the still undefeated teams and get the benefit of the doubt with the forced win this week, but I'm not going to punish them or their coach for not being able to play, since he has been rolling up to this point in the season. This week's number four is Old Dominion. They jumped from sixth last week over the stagnant number five Baylor, as Baylor had the recent loss and a bye this week, so I feel the Monarchs have earned the number four spot, but the Bears are right behind them at number five. Next up, UAB jumps up one spot to number six this week with their win and number three's loss. And now at seventh is Stanford, dropping from three this week. I wanted to put them lower after the throttling that they took from Notre Dame, but I am trying to remain unbiased against FIU like I've said in the past few weeks, so didn't want to drop them too low. Eighth is FIU and ninth is ASU. I am trying to stay unbiased with FIU since it is my team, but these two remain the same since both teams won this week, and FIU has a 5-1 record and ASU has a 4-1. FIU's loss is to a user game. You know, there's a few things going on. ASU's loss is a little bit more recent. But, you know, mainly the user win or the user loss not hurting them too much and FIU having one more win. Now, jumping up for the first time this season is Vandy at number 10. The Commodores won a big one this week to jump up to 4-2, and Indiana loses again to drop them to Vandy's old spot of 11th with a 4-3 record. And still, rounding out the bottom is Bowling Green at 2-4. With another loss this week, they really need to get their act together if they want to make a bowl game. That'll do it for the Week 7 Power Ranking. I am interested to see where we go from here with multiple teams still looking at undefeated seasons, but we do have two teams that are really sliding and might have a fight in the second half of the season to make a bowl game. There are plenty of conference championships still at play too, as three teams are undefeated, six teams only have one loss, and then one team has two losses but still could potentially be in there. So very interesting second half of the season coming up for the Delusionals Dynasty. The next segment is the game of the week. Each week we select one game to highlight for this upcoming week and get some quotes from the coach on their expectations. We have another game of the week this week coming out of Oxford, Mississippi, as the Vanderbilt Commodores go on the road to play Ole Miss. We reached out to Vanderbilt's offensive coordinator, Lloyd Christmas, to see what he had to say about this upcoming matchup. So far, I think that the team has played hard. We've had some ups and downs, but I think we are starting to find our stride on offense. The defense has been making big plays for us all year and have made some key stops when we needed them so that our offense can start off in good field position. Nate Johnson is a straight stud. His mobility and ability to extend the play has been key to our success on offense. We need to clean up the interception and turnovers, But that's on me, not the players. Ole Miss is a tough ball club. They're ranked number 4 for good reason, with an explosive offense. Jackson Dart is one of the best in the country, along with Trey Harris, but I have confidence that our defense will go out there and make some big plays for us. As far as my job on offense, we have to get the ball out in space and maybe try to stay away from the middle of that defense, because they got some studs on the defensive line. Again, it will be key for Nate to use his legs and extend plays for us. Well, I hope Coach Beth and his boys can pull it off, because that'd be a great upset coming out of Oxford, but we'll see what they can do. Anyway, thank you to everybody for tuning in. I appreciate it. Like I said, week 1 of college football this week should, when this video is being posted, most of the week 1 game should be tomorrow, but there will be a few since I'm trying to post this on Friday, so we'll see if that actually happens. Hope all of you enjoy it. I will be trying to upload more frequently with these videos. Schedule's been crazy. When y'all are seeing this, I'll actually be on my fantasy football draft trip, so we'll actually be in Nashville. You know, not a kind of a coincidence that I'm wearing this jersey tonight, but I will be there, and we'll be up in Tennessee for our draft. But I'm hoping that once I get back from this trip, I can really get down and start editing these videos more and get them out more frequently, going to at least twice a week. I'm also going to start trying to post these as short form, so we'll see if I can get that done in time for some of these videos. But anyway, I appreciate all the love, all the support. Make sure you like and subscribe. Check out the live streams here on YouTube and on Twitch at CMoneyAZ on both. Like I've said, Sports Scramble Media, they've been streaming their games. It's Big ZD has been streaming his on Twitch too, so y'all make sure to check those guys out. But anyway, I appreciate all the love, and I'll see y'all next time. Thank you, and
see you.